What's up, everybody? Welcome to the stream. We are playing some Marvel Snap tonight. Let me turn up the volume a bit. So make sure the music is just the right level. Hope you all are doing well. I've been playing some Marvel Snap here and there today. I've been trying to play with this deck idea using Cerebro and the mutant that copies on ongoing effects, whose name escapes me all of a sudden. I'll just show you the deck. So this is the deck I've been working off of. So this deck here, you can kind of see it. Mystique, yeah. So try to use three power cards comboed with Cerebro and Mystique, and then using Bast as a means to get even more three-powered cards. So Mystique will be three power, Cerebro could be three power. One of the keys to this deck, and probably a crutch, if you will, is Adam Warlock, making him a 2-3, because people don't expect it. I'll play Bast, and then I'll play Adam Warlock. But if I get Adam Warlock out, it's like, just, I pull my whole deck. So, this is kind of like the core deck here. I have Valkyrie, which turns Cerebro and Mystique into three power cards. I included Rogue because I've been seeing a lot of Patriot decks, and they're really annoying, so I figured Rogue is a cheap enough card to interrupt those ongoing cards without jeopardizing my ongoing cards, which I have a lot of. Colossus, Armor, Sarah, for example. But here's the thing. I haven't even been using this deck. I actually tried something different. I even tried a four-power card deck because I had all these variants of Crystal I just got. This one, the Dan Hip. Can't go wrong with Dan Hip variants. They're very cool. But even cooler, I got this Crystal variant, which is really cool. Crystal is one of those cards, it's like, how the hell do I even use this card? It's not very common. I hardly ever see it anywhere. So I was kind of like, well, what if I can make a deck with Crystal and other four-power cards like Enchantress, Moon Girl, and then combo them with Cerebro and Mystique? And I was like, I don't know. There's also Medusa, who becomes a 2-4. That's a pretty high-quality card in a deck like this. Then combo that with Forge into, you know, possibly Nightcrawler. Ant-Man becomes a 1-4 to Forge into Yondu. So basically it's like Forge either into Yondu, Nightcrawler, or Zabu. And then everything else hopefully plays out the way you'd expect. Problem is, I haven't played this deck that much, and I don't think it's very good. But this other deck, which is just another play off of this deck here, little Cerebro. This is called Cerebro. Anyways, someone who plays a lot more Marvel Snap than me said, start putting Quake into your deck. You'll start seeing some interesting results. So I said, okay, Quake's a 2-3. Cerebro and Mystique, it fits into my three-power archetype here. So I was like, all right, well, let me do Quake. Let me try something different. I'll do Doctor Strange comboed with Multiple Man. And then the usual. So Bass and Adam Warlock. Now you might see Domino and America Chavez. Why is America Chavez in this deck? I hardly know. But because Domino and America Chavez are only drawn on their specific turns, it essentially makes my deck only 10 cards, if you will. So on my very first turn, I'm drawing 4 cards out of 10. So my theory is that it increases the chances that I'm going to get this core combo of cards. Multiple Man plus Doctor Strange duplicates that card. Sentinel duplicates himself. And so hopefully with Bast turning Cerebro and Mystique into a 3-3 each, I'll have a pretty solid collection of cards that I can boost, hopefully consistently, is the goal. So that every game I have all three locations are hard to deal with, is the idea. But all that being said, It's still probably not a very good deck. But I have shockingly been winning some games, my last couple of games. I think because people don't expect Quake to be there. I had an amazing game where I had Rickety Bridge on one location, right? Now, Rickety Bridge is if there's more than one card at the entire location, it destroys all the cards. And so this player put all their cards on one location, and then I used Quake to flop the locations around. Suddenly, all of their cards were on Rickety Bridge, and they all got destroyed. It was pretty fantastic. So, one of my gripes was that there's too many damn locations now. And so, even though, look at this Kang variant, ugh, the pixel variants in this game are not good. I'm sorry, they're not good at all. Ooh, a Robbie Reyes variant. That's cool too. Wow. That's really cool. Oh, this is cool too. Oh, the Dan Hips. This one's so amazing. I love this rogue variant. Anyways, I generally don't spend money on variants. Master Mold, not worth 6,000. I've also determined that no card in the token shop I think is worth 6,000 other than the ones that they've declared are only going to cost 6,000. So it's use at your own discretion. But I'm saving my tokens for a big bad is my plan. But anyways, I'm going to switch out my deck, go back to Cerebe. Whoa! But anyways, thank you guys for joining me tonight for some Marvel Snap. See, already off to a good start. Already off to a great start, Bast and Adam Warlock. That's perfect. I just want to start with that. The question is, where do I think they'll play? Okay, I think I'm good. Son of a bitch. I think we're tied. Supersonic man out of you. Don't stop me now. Good time. I'm having a ball. All right, he didn't want to deny my Adam Warlock. That's fine. Oh, it's still tied. Bastard. He's just juicing out the sunspot, apparently. All right, well now he's got to deal with Cerebro, so. What is this guy doing? Is he just gonna play Galactus? I'll explode. All right, fine. Fine. This guy is a clown. I don't know what this is. This might not be a real player. It's very strange. The only downside is that I don't get a turn six draw. Oh, okay. Oh wait, that still will work. Is he gonna play what's a who's it's on this side? Oh wow. I might win right here. Because I don't think Captain Marvel can really help. Yeah, I have a much bigger lead. When's the next giveaway? The next giveaway should be this Friday. I don't think we've announced it, but insider info for y'all. But it's not my giveaway. Skullgirls giveaways. Okay. Oh, you know what? It's not for a little while. My bad. So I do have the next giveaway. I was gonna do it on March 31st, but I can't do it on that night, so I pushed it to April 7th. So I'm gonna have the first giveaway of the next monthly event. So April 7th, and we're gonna have another giveaway on April 21st. So mark that in your calendar. All right, the goal tonight is to get these missions done. Win a location with four cards. Complete hard daily missions. That's what I'm trying to do here. I got to win three more matches. Moon Knight with a number at the end. Only losers have numbers at the end of their names. Word of advice, if your name is taken in a video game, just change your name. Just do something different. Don't put numbers at the end of your name. It's very odd. I'm just saying. what to do here? I'm looking for Quake. I think I thought this was Quake. It's not. It's Domino. Ooh, that rickety bridge. Oh, look at this. Colossus into Bast. I'm going to get rid of Bast. No problem. Then I'm going to have some fun. I'm going to switch things up here. So we got Quake. We got Adam Warlock. Let's see if I get lucky. Oh, Rickety Bridge going in the middle. That hurts me a little bit. That's okay. Gives me that card draw. I still got Cerebro, so... Madness! Do I even worry about this zone here? I don't know. Oh wait, I want to do this backwards. So let's do Sentinel and Cerebro, and then I'll do Mystique into something else here. Out of cards. Oh, I got my whole deck that time. Wow. So I could do Mystique. I'd love to get another one drop. So this guy goes first. I can't destroy this with Shang-Chi, but he might play something here. Let's just see. Just wondering if it's worth having the Mystique. That's the question. Because Mystique won't give me any boost there because she's a 3-0. Oh, this thing messes everything up anyways. That's the problem. Yeah, and even playing America Chavez was messed stuff up. Let's do this. See what happens. Oh, he fell for it. Okay. That's a 9. This is going to go up to a 9. That's a Wolfsbane. Oh, another Wolfsbane. That's going to get destroyed. Wow. Thank you. the BM at the end. Thank you for the hydrate, Osprey. That guy thought he was gonna beat me. He probably could have if I had done something different. Sometimes this game is a literal coin flip. But I can't handle the saltiness, so I mute everybody because I'm a hypocrite. I'm gonna do Bass into Adam Warlock. Cheers to the Warlock. Go, Adam. Oh, yeah. Ooh, yeah. Coming in, yeah. I would love another one drop. A 1-3 if it exists, but I don't think it does. Because then I get into situations like this. Which kind of suck, but I'd rather keep my Warlock going. Oh, you got Bast yourself. Is this a copycat deck? What? What is this? This is a copycat deck. This player is like... This has to be AI nonsense or something. I don't know. I have Mystique and Cerebro. Wow. Alright, I drew all my cards. This is the only option. And I hope it holds up. What are they going to play right here? They don't have a Cerebro. At least as far as I can tell. They're probably going to do the same turn though, right? Cerebro there. And Mystique. Wow, that's a trip, man. But, I think I got the bigger boost here. Oh shoot, just 7 turns. I forgot about that. Oh no, why did I snap like an idiot? I was just doing it as a joke. Oh my gosh. Alright, 2, 4, 6, and pray. Can they play anything here that could beat me? I don't think so. Definitely here though. This doesn't beat anybody. I'm such a schmuck. I should have risked it and played it over here. Cerebro. Oh. That actually helps me somewhat. So I think I tie. We might tie here. Unless these get destroyed, which one of them probably will. Don't. I think we tied. Wow, exact same thing. Unbelievable. How annoying Go get your own deck, bro. It's my deck. Put on Fist Tower. I haven't tried that combo in a while. The Kingpin Magneto. You son of a bitch. Buzz off. Banzors. Friggin' dork. Dude, this clown at opening hand, hood and a viper. What a jackass. Get out of here. Ah, clever. Is this asshole again? Dude.
Always lucky.
Shuri's lab. Dude, this guy's got one of those annoying ass. I'm gonna put every single card in the deck that, like, messes with them. I'm gonna make a mess up deck. I'm gonna mess with them. It's very annoying. He probably has Galactus. Watch. What a dum-dum. What is this guy's weirdo deck? Get a life. Now, Cerebro unfortunately doesn't help me that much. But I might have to do it anyways. Or I could just bring... I can't play Doctor Strange because the asshole made it a turn 6. I could fake him out and bring it over here. This is all jacked up though. That's the problem. Oh, it's a Master Mold deck. What a freaking clown, dude. What a clown. Seriously. Actual clown. Like, no doubt about it. Alright, this is... I'm gonna lose here, but he hasn't snapped because this person has no idea what they're doing either. So... doesn't matter. It's like, dude, buzz off. That's the thing. When you have morons who have decks like this that are like brand new, never seen before, Master Mold. Like, this guy probably spent 6,000 tokens on Master Mold. What the hell is this song? Anyways. I'm not playing that guy anymore. He can have his one token. His one cube. Good on you. Alright, so now we got a random ass deck. This round is going to be a complete joke. There's another one. Iceman and Korg. These people think they're playing Hearthstone. Let's see if I can do Doctor Strange at Luke's Bar once I get some more three power cards here. Or anywhere, really. Oh, crap. Devil Dino ruins my plans, though. Barf. Maybe not, actually. Nick Primes! Thanks for the follow. Double Iceman. Hey guys, I'm new player. Was wondering what our top three Series 3 cards to get for the free one. That's a really great question. Let me go. Oh man. How did this happen? Enchantress? Ugh. You son of a bitch. God, screw these assholes, man. Well, I wouldn't spend much tokens if you don't have them. I was just saying, like, generally tokens you kind of want to. I like to save my tokens for the permanent Series 5 cards like Galactus, Thanos, and Kang. I mean, I have all three of them already. So my rule of thumb right now is that the rate that they are dropping cards from Series 5 to Series 4, meaning they're going from 6,000 tokens to 3,000, is almost like the same rate that you would save up to 3,000 or 6,000 tokens anyways, assuming you're playing regularly and getting those loot crates with the token drops. So, I mean, I'm just like, save till you have 6,000 and then just wait. But Series 3, they don't actually sort these by series, do they? I have my old school, this is my Onslaught deck is like my original first deck with some of the classic cards. But all of these are good. Ant-Man is clutch. Misty Knight, I just love the card. But I used to have a theory, like always have at least one card that didn't have any powers in case you got Washington, D.C. And so Misty Knight was kind of my card for that. Star-Lord's probably one of the best early game cards you can get. That's almost always a 2/5, assuming you are paying attention to what your opponent's up to. Armor is a fantastic card. Still, it was people never used armor for like a few months, but it's made a comeback. You know, these are all so just a good counter card that's very cheap to play. Mr. Fantastic is essentially a 3/6. That's pretty hard to beat. Punisher, I don't know why he's in this deck. Punisher is a 3/5 essentially, a 3/6 as well. Actually, no. If depending on where you play him, he's also a 3/6, so cheap but has a lot of power. Claw is a great five cost play.
Essentially, it's a 5. It's a 5-10 because it adds 6 to the other locations. And then combo that all with Spectrum, which is like, these are all, I'm pretty sure, Series 3 cards. They're kind of like opening cards. But if you're asking me what cards to spend your tokens on, I can't really help you there. It's more like, what deck do you have the most fun playing? Because if you're playing this game for any other reason than to maximize how much fun you're having, then you probably shouldn't be playing this. So. No hablo inglés. That's all right. Howdy. But let's see. And then early game tends to be mostly these ongoing cards and a couple of reveal cards. They're really easy to understand. But then you quickly move into more of the discard style of gameplay, which includes these types of cards. These are, a lot of these are Series 3 and pretty common as well. Can't go wrong with a classic discard deck. Ignore a Helicarrier, that shouldn't be in there. But you've got Wolverine, you've got Morbius and the Collector. Lady Sif to juice up your Apocalypse as a great like final turn 6 play. Blade as well. So anyways, these are, you know, trying to go after these cards as well. I mean, I haven't seen a Series 3 card in my token shop in months because I have them all. Anyways, and then my recommendation is to keep an eye out in the shop for the, like, they've been doing like Token Tuesdays. Those are really, really good deals. So if you have nothing else to spend your gold on, you might want to spend it on those token deals, because 700 gold for 600 or 700 tokens, whatever it was, that's not a bad deal. There he is. Oops, son of a bitch. I see you, Master Mold. Asshole. Playing Snap for a while, but gave you an error and lost your account. Did you contact customer support and get your account back? And you recommend people leveling collection? Honestly, if you're not going to spend your gold on offers, spend your gold on refreshing your missions. I've heard from many people that if you're planning on doing a extended session, like let's say you've done all your missions, right? But you're like, hey, I can still play for another hour or two. Spend the 120 gold and you'll get two more missions immediately, and then finish those missions. Because the best deal in the entire game is 120 gold for two more missions, because it's almost always credits, usually like 100 credits or 50 credits, plus points towards the season pass. So that's about it. Gordo has a rebuttal. Gordo plays a lot though, so he can answer some questions as well. Right. I'm just saying that if you can afford certain bundles, you know, go for it. But, you know, I would say your average mobile game player is going to be free to play and is not spending money, either because they can't or they just don't want to. Yeah, well, still, same goes for that. By the way, video game update. MLB The Show 2023 comes out this week. It should be arriving in my mailbox. So you might see me playing some baseball on stream pretty soon. I know you all have missed it. You're huge baseball fans. I get it. Just keep an eye out for that. Let's do this. Let's play multiple man over here. And then... because the freaking monster doesn't even matter. Ruins everything. Whatever. Oh, here we go again. Another Shuri nonsense bullcrap deck. Brander. All right, I might have to quit this one. The Brander. Goodbye. The sea. What? So I play this here, I probably can't win. They're gonna play something here. So I'm pretty much screwed. Cause playing Shang-Chi here destroys this, fine, but then they play something here. I'm gonna get out of there. I'm just having too much fun with this deck though, so I'm gonna keep it up. Oh, story! If you're watching live, you can hear some sweet tunes. If you're watching the VOD, you're just hearing me sing along to the songs in my head. Ugh. There's so many locations, though, that are just like, they mess with this deck. That's the problem. That's the one major thing that says I probably shouldn't keep playing this deck. I was hoping that it's versatile enough that I can play around it, and it sometimes is, but for the most part, it's just annoying. And then we have Cosmo, who comes out of nowhere and ruins everything. It's a good wife. Oh, here it comes. I'll play America Chavez. Maybe she can steal the win here. I am kind of curious. So I don't think he's going to play anything that... I don't think he's going to play anything to Xandar. I think it's all going to be on Nidalee or whatever.
But I don't think he's got enough to beat me on the Davalier. We'll see. Yep, that won't do it. Good job, NetDeck. They saw what the guy who works on this game tweeted out and made that exact same deck. The problem is that look, I make net decks, right? I'll be like, that looks like a lot of fun. I'm gonna make that deck and give it a try, right? I honestly believe there's nothing wrong with that. The problem with that is that oftentimes I will find myself confused because it's not my deck, right? It's like I play better with the decks that like I was inspired by and I went and I made it, right? So just a tip for yourself. You can do whatever you want. And there's nothing wrong with making a net deck. I'm just salty that I'm losing so much. We're gonna hope for Doctor Strange here for the memes. What? What are you doing, bro? Okay. Don't know. This guy's just joking around, I guess. That was very odd. What? What am I playing against? Who are these clowns? Leech? What? He's leeched a bunch of rocks, bro. I don't even know what's going on. Get a life, dude. Dude, what a clown. Right. I'm going back to my ridiculous Thanos deck. Nothing. Terrible hand. Watch this. The old switcheroo. I think I'm gonna go back to my other Cerebro deck. This is so stupid. Terrible. I didn't even see what they played. This game sucks. Let's go, M'Baku. Forgot you were in this deck. I love M'Baku. M'Baku is a terrible card, but he's hysterical. He makes my life much more enjoyable. I almost always forget that I have him in my deck, and he'll pop out, and I've literally won games, and I forgot that he was in my deck. It's the best feeling in the world. That's the only reason to put M'Baku in your deck. I guess he'll win you games when you forget about him. You're like, oh crap, I forgot he was in my deck. The goal is to keep him in your deck. See, I don't want him in my hand, I want him in my deck. After 5-3, add a rock. Okay, whatever. Boo! Whatever. So, this Thanos deck isn't much different than the traditional Thanos deck with Lockjaw and everything. It's just slightly weaker, I would say. Sorry, I got Kazar. That becomes a 1-1. This becomes a 1-2. This becomes a 1-whatever. Oh, cool. Yeah, good. Go ahead and snap. Boys are back in town. Oh yeah, I gotta end my turn, don't I? In town. Dude, hurry up! Clown, change your move. Let's see what you do. Did you play the exact same thing? Look at that! Wow, the exact same thing! Oh, he did Nova first. Wow, who'd have thunk it? I'll risk my four cubes here. Wow, what a freaking loser! I gotta start playing Nimrod once I get this variant. The universe shall be set right. Man. Hello, I am man. Here we go. Another Patriot deck. Can't get enough of these. Wow.
Systems go.
Seriously, at the end of the turn, end of the game. What's up, Overdrive? Just getting my ass kicked by a bunch of losers constantly. By a friggin' Juggernaut. You know, you remember Juggernaut? That's a card that exists in this game. Tough. You play Mindstone, you're up to six cards. And it's kind of like you have to play something or else you're in trouble. Hey, I just put on the Guardians of the Galaxy soundtrack. Nothing special. I mean, it is special, but it's not my doing. I think Ivan is a bot, by the way. Basically means that if I don't win, then I suck at Marvel. At Marvel Snap.
Hey, this is bullshit, by the way. This Morbius is supposed to be fixed, where it only gains if it was in play. That's a bug right there. A juicy Thanos. Here comes Shang-Chi. No room for M'Baku. That's the real reason I put M'Baku in this deck, to see that animation, because it's so stupid. It's so wonderful. Surrender! Do I play Kang right here? Thanos! So the time stone will give me access to Shang-Chi. Yeah! You're gonna get him in your Ultron deck? Awesome. They're gonna Shang-Chi on their next turn.
Right, daddy's all right. Miranda.
Oh, I gotta end my turn, don't I? Face the might of Shang-Chi! Oh, Thanos is protected from Shang-Chi.
That is all right. Just seem a little weird. Surrender.
Oh, not playing into Lockjaw. Oh, they're gonna do it next. Okay. So they're going to get Mjolnir in hand to buff up Thor. So I got to prepare for that. But here, I think I should play Cloak and move Thanos over then. Right? Oh. Every so often I'll use, so I've had Kang, I've played Kang a lot, and so far what I'm left with when I play Kang is like, why am I using Kang? Like, what does he provide? And I think it's just like any other card, it's like you just don't know. Sometimes you'll play Kang and you'll be like, oh crap, I didn't know he had that in his deck. You know, and then they might be so embarrassed they quit or something. Because you can always snap on the same turn that you play Kang, and you'll get your snap back. So you can snap. It's like a free snap. You don't have to, like, question it. You just snap, right? That's really powerful. Because sometimes it's like, they're just like, all right, I'm out. And them showing the Mighty Thor, like, you saw it. I was like, oh, they're going to get Mjolnir in their hand. So maybe I should do something different. You know, that doesn't happen all the time, but you could say that for, like, all the cards in this game. It's like, sometimes you have amazing plays, sometimes you don't. This is a terrible opening hand. I might just play Cloak just to have something on the board here. A little Hearthstone strategy. Gotta play something. Because the what's it called? They call that not a cadence deck or a rhythm deck. Tempo! The tempo is off. Oh, look at this though. Ongoing disabled. Okay, pal. You've been leeched! Oh, Captain Marvel. Wow. All right, Captain. There you go. I got a BM. Could have been AI. If I can beat him, it usually means that it wasn't a real person, right? I don't actually know what I'm doing. Handsome Tomato. That's a good name. No title, though, so probably not a real person. Ooh, the Quantum Realm. I'm tempted just to play stuff in the Quantum Realm because it already gives my stones a boost. The real people
only use the current meta deck. That's for sure. Goodness. Oh. Alright, I have to go to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
Alright. Give me that cube. Let's see if I can hit rank 50 tonight. My goal is to hit rank 70 by the end of the month, by the end of the season. That's a big ask. Whoops. Get some credits.
But my mind.
Ye Ginger Commodore.
Hey, ooh, the rickety bridge. Ugh,
where's Colossus when you need him?
La 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 la.
Ooh, the Hulkster. Oh no, dude, I got machine gunned in a game earlier. That's where they do Shang-Chi into Mystique and then Gambit. I was like, buzz off. I invented that deck. Know it. I freaking wrote it. Why am I going first? Why am I flipping first? So they're just playing Hellcal and discarding? I guess I could just play Shang-Chi and get rid of this stupid Giganto. I'm tempted to play Leech though, because Leech has just been so powerful lately. But it's hard to say no to a clean Shang-Chi here. They switched it up. They put Hellcal over there, okay. Whatever.
All right, so here's the thing. When you're in this situation where you have, you're winning here and you're winning here, if you can play a card that also takes the lead in the third spot, you have a really good shot at winning. So it's always good to snap on that. I might still lose because I don't know what the hell this deck is doing. It's some traditional discard deck, but like not quite. Oh, it's hella, obviously. Okay. Wow! Wow! No! I tied, though. They still win. Ah, crap. See, anyways, look at the placement of their cards. They just, you don't know, right? So, that was a decent snap opportunity. I should have predicted that they had hella. I mean, I played the hella out of hella for months, and I'm tempted to go back because it's probably my favorite deck of all time. Just the good old fashioned discard deck. My mind for another cup of wine. Oh. Where are my cards? I've got like nothing in my hand. It's. Love with me. Here we go, another Shuri deck. Me on I. High on believing. Say goodbye. I am believing you're in love with me. Hooked on a feeling. I still don't think I can win, but could I play something there? Could I play? Oops, let's do this. Let's do that. And then let's do, why not? Let's do that. I'm gonna lose, so I'm just gonna retreat later. Escaped. That's the worst part about this game, and I think it's getting worse, is that it's not a lot of fun to lose in this game. They haven't done a very good job at creating for the player the experience of you put up a good fight but you lost, right? Like the spirit of competition has gotten worse in this game, at least for me personally. But as someone who works in game development, I can tell you that if one person feels it, many people feel it. And I think that's the one thing that they are going to have to figure out. And I think, honestly, it's simple. I thought of it earlier today. I was like, I think it's just they have so many new locations now. Like, it's so spread out. There's so many locations. And it is exciting. Like, it adds to the variance and the uniqueness of each game, right? And I know that their whole philosophy is like, hey, each game is no more than 3 minutes. But guess what? When you're in the game, it feels a lot longer than 3 minutes. That's for sure. So it's kind of like, I think what they're going to have to do, and I bet you they're going to do it, is that they're going to look at their entire collection of locations and shrink those down from season to season. They're going to be like, all right, this season we're introducing these cards. These are the locations we're going to have. And they're going to move on and they're going to do that. That would be my guess. Because right now it's like, it's almost like if you've played Hearthstone, it's like, it's that those 3 months before the next year of Hearthstone where like every single card is available in Standard. And it's just like, it's like so annoying. Because in games, it's the walls of the sandbox that create the fun, right? It's like, it's the limitations of the rule set that infuses a game with all the fun. So I think the sandbox walls of Marvel Snap are way too big right now, and they gotta focus it down. And I think they will. They're a pretty talented group. So, am I effed? I might be effed. Cause they got Cosmo, beautiful Cosmo. I'm gonna. What's up, Pink Boy?
Pink Boy. Pink.
Go away. Should I play Thanos here? Or Kang here? There's Namor. Oh, hey Sam, for the rubber band, man. Man. Oh, they played somebody on Namor. Oh, it's so clutch, you asshole. Still good though. Victory. That was a good play, Jack. I still think you're a bot. Whoa! Hey, you say off of the rubber band, man. Man. Starts changing. They better have ego. I think using the title ego equals snap, like it should increase the odds of actually getting ego. That would probably break the game though. I'm gonna make a poll about MLB the Show, by the way. Man. Um, Wow, I played everything to the Danger Room, hoping the Danger Room would destroy it, and the Danger Room did not destroy it. Hey, thanks, pal. This guy's full on. Let's see if Venom gets destroyed. It didn't get destroyed that time, so I could try it again. So the good thing about Kang, because now Venom might get zapped by Danger Room. Still, I don't know how I win this. I literally have nothing in my hand. Literally nothing in my hand. Escaped. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me away. I just got a new card, and she is awful. Where is she? She's a 4/2. Shauna. Ugh. What a terrible card. It's so bad that I want to use it. Add a random one-cost card to each location. Let's do it. Let's make a garbage Shauna deck. No offense to Shauna, by the way. I don't know nothing about Shauna, what her character's like. But, my God. What am I supposed to do with this? We're going to make a one-cost deck. Heck, I should have used her in my Thanos deck. I'm going to put Super Scroll in it. Where the F is Kazar? There he is. I'm going to take you, baby. Alright, we want some awesome one drops. Nightcrawler, standard. M'Baku, standard. Rocket Raccoon, the best. Ant-Man, the goat. Bass, just to beef up all these frickin' losers. Hawkeye, let's do it. Sunspot, Sunspot's probably not that good. Titania, just for funsies. Yondu, because Yondu. Squirrel Girl. Oh, man. When was the last time you used Squirrel Girl? Alright, here we go. What is this garbage song? All my heroes.
I want the classics, and that's it. This just in. No! They have Killmonger. Ouch. I gotta bait out their Killmonger.
Ooh, child.
That's my Ant-Man.
Ooh, child.
Dude, get a life. Freaking Scorpion, man. The worst card.
Someday.
Maybe I should have had a Sunspot. Alright, here comes their Killmonger. What's up, El Panamega? All right, here comes Killmonger. Killmonger. Whoa! They retreated! Holy cow! Didn't see that coming. Alright, Shauna. You broke the frame. You're just that good.
Ooh, child.
Oh, come on. Let's go. Turn one. Let's go.
Ow!
Why does this game hate me? Alright, maybe I do have to put Sunspot in here. What? What are you doing? How'd they even do that? Wait a second. That was turn two. This is a three cost card. How did they play a three-cost card on turn two? Oh, because Tinkerer's Workshop. Asshole.
Cherry Bomb!
Here we go. Come on, Shauna. Show us what you're made of. Cherry Bomb! Absolute madness. This is probably more valuable, the Kazar. I think I should put Sunspot in this deck, now that I think about it. Cherry Pie! Come on! How am I winning these games? Is everybody terrible now? It's because of Shauna. Nobody sees it coming. They don't know what to do. That's the key to this game. I'm learning right now. Play cards that nobody's playing. It boggles their minds. Everyone thinks they're so good. I'm turning up flashlight. No! So I thought about including Shauna in my other Cerebro deck because she's a 2-drop. And a lot of 1-cost cards are 2-power or less. There's only Titania, Zero, and Blade, I think, that are 1-cost cards that are over 2 or 1 power. You son of a bitch. Fuck. It finally backfired, everybody. Shauna, no good? What? King Matt. M'Baku might not be ideal for this deck, but who knows? I think I need to put Sunspot. Maybe take M'Baku out and put Sunspot in. Oddly enough, I thought I'd be playing cards every turn, but this has not been the case. What? To each location. That's pretty nuts. Ooh, double Ant-Man. I can't play any one cost cards though here. Under the sun, under the sun, under the sun, under the sun. Oh, did Zero cast it on Vass? Oh no. Let's see. And a landslide. Eight from reality. In your eyes. Look up to the sky and see. I'm just a poor boy. I need no sympathy. Oh well. All right. I'm starting to brainstorm a little bit more here with Shauna.
Mama just killed a man.
All right, so what we want to do here. Okay. Oops.
It all away, Mama. Ooh. If I'm not back again this time tomorrow, carry on.
So I don't know about Super Scroll. Pretty studly buddly though. So the key here is so far has been Sunspot. I like Nightcrawler still. Rocket Raccoon and Baku, I don't know. But we're probably going to have four cards at every single location, every single game, right? So we want to play into that as much as we can. So obviously we want cards like my man Mojo.
Mama. Sometimes wish I'd never been fired off.
I still actually, what my homeboy, Blue Marvel, might still come into play here. Maybe Valkyrie. Let's try it. Let's get some strong five costs, five plays.
Scalaboosh, Scalaboosh.
Galileo, Galileo.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Ant-Man, in.
And I'll let you go.
Bass is still pretty good. Mamma Mia, let me go. I still like Titania. Let's do Bat. Let's do quick Hawkeye, our friend Hawkeye. And baby. Angel needs a buff. I think it should be this flies out of your deck or your hand to replace it. That'd be cool. I want to make sure I have a plenty of one drops, but actually, I think Iceman is stronger than, I don't know. Iceman or versus Yondu, better to have them both if I can. Nothing really matters anyone can see. Spectrum might be good in this deck, by the way, because ongoing, we got Mojo and Ant-Man. And that's about it. We got Kazar, we got Blue Marvel, so it's possible. It's a possibility. I'm going to roll with Iceman for now, this garbage pile deck. Wind blows. Mustache Owlbear. I don't see a mustache, you bum. I don't know where you're going. Bam, 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 bam Timmy. Wait, did I put Nightcrawler in? Nightcrawler is pretty key. I should probably get Nightcrawler in here. Ah! Ha! Oh, we got a Galactus deck. Oh, yep. There's no doubt about it. I'm gonna play it on Luke's bar, you freaking jerk. Ah! I saw that coming. That's a tough Galactus, because they would have to play Galactus probably here is the ideal spot. They could have played it here, but they must not have gotten all they wanted. I've played enough Galactus in my time that it's like, it's not a sure thing. None of these decks are a sure thing. Bow, bow. Oof. What? What are you doing? This cannot be. Oh, look, they got Angel. What? Oh, don't forget about Zero. Yeah, perfect. Give me that Valkyrie. We got that Fleetwood Mac coming in hot. The wind GG's. Victory. He bows together.
My heart. It's few bands that are as great as Fleetwood Mac. My God. It's like effortless. It's like, it's so good. It's why they're called classic rock, because they are classic. I saw some meme the other day about Fleetwood Mac that was so funny. It was kind of like making fun of Taylor Swift. Which, you know, may or may not be fair. I don't know. Whatever. What do I care? But it was like Taylor Swift writes songs about her ex-boyfriends. And it's like Fleetwood Mac writes songs about their ex-boyfriends and makes their ex-boyfriends play music in the band. Because one of the coolest things, I don't know how cool it is, but one of the greatest things about Fleetwood Mac and what made their music so powerful was that it was like the entire band was like sleeping with each other. So they had all these insane like love triangles going on. And they just write music about it. And then go up on stage together and sing. I was like, that's incredible. Like, to have the guts to do that is pretty amazing. Wait, so why is this buff to 3? Because it's 2 in blue marble, yeah? Oof, excuse me. So this is buffed. Okay. Ha 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 ha
Let's go, Jay Bird. Oh, it's the asteroid. Ah, nothing on the asteroid. You guys are jerks. Krishna. Ooh, sentinels. Let's go. Give me them sentinels. Come on, dude. If I time this right, I may be able to hit this guy with Valkyrie on their Black Panther, yeah? Let's see. Oh, it's a white tiger. That's fine. Oh, but I can't play Valkyrie here. What I could do is do Mojo, maybe? That. Let's just do that. Let's see what happens. They're gonna do what's his name? Oh crap. I forgot about that. There's Odin. Odin doesn't win here though. He doesn't win there either. Oh, he does it twice. Yeah, that's right. Mystery variant, here we go. Ugh. Gross. The pixel variants are so bad, I'm sorry. I like them less and less. It's the same dude. They hired one guy to do all the pixel variants, and none of them are that great. Now, here's the exception to the rule, okay? If you actually look at it from a distance, which maybe that's why they did it this way. If you go to Cable, I love this variant. I absolutely love Cable. Cable's one of my favorite cards. I think this might be my favorite variant, but I generally use this one. Like, look, if you do Cable at a distance, right? So favorite him. Look at him from a distance. Where is he? There, see? Then it kind of looks okay. But even then, you're like, what am I looking at? It's a mess. It's not very good. I'm sorry, G Angle. Your pixel variants are not as good as I was hoping. I want her back. Ooh, Project Pegasus right off the bat. Oh, let's do this. Let's go. Forge into who? Deadpool? Sunspot? Oh, this is tricky. Because I'm winning. So they have to play something here to beat me, but it's going to send Titania over here. Oh, and Limbo? My God. Ah. Oh, a Sauron deck. Uh-oh.
When I die. That's the best.
Oh, thank you for my Titania bag. I appreciate it. Oh, it's rough. But I think they're going to beat me here. But I've got Blue Marvel coming your way. So here we go.
When you die.
Oh no! Oh, okay. Oh, final turn. What? Okay. They gotta play something big right here to win. What do they got? What do you actually have? Nope. Not good enough. Not good enough, AJ! Shauna is kicking your butt. In Jesus. Place that's the best. Hold on, I gotta find a picture. Sunspot. What again? Let's kick it off with Shauna and Sunspot. God. That's not good. That's too much. Oof. Oh. But dude. Get your cowbells ready. On a day, hey.
Time's up.
Hey. Do blue sky. So I do have Nightcrawler in this deck. I think I was saying that earlier. I was like, do I have Nightcrawler? Yes, I do. Oh! Victory. Couldn't handle the snapback. See, this is why you gotta watch my streams live, so you can hear those sweet, sweet tunes. So this is a good spot for Valkyrie right here. Because even if they destroy my monster, it's like, whatever.
Mr. Blue.
I don't know what this guy's doing. He hasn't played anything. It's turn three. Mr. Blue Sky. Hold up. Oh! Ooh, Titania on their side. Wow. Is Project Pegasus like the featured location right now? It's like we're getting a lot of these. Got my own Titania. Cosmo. Not gonna help you there, bro. Well, kills my Valkyrie, but whatever. Opponent
snapped. My lady.
This is a great song. Listen to those lyrics. I gotta end my turn, don't I? Another Shuri deck. Another loser deck. The chiller pina coladas.
Ooh, Bar Sinister.
Galactus.
Oh, here we go, Galactus. They wouldn't play Galactus here.
For midnight. To look for.
Wow. Okay. Hey, thanks. What a clown! Wow. Wait. Dude, this is an uphill battle, bro. Quit. Ouch, that actually hurt me a lot. It's alright. Because I got Hobgoblin. See you later. Oh, thanks for the Hobgoblin! We did it! Level 50 on the dot tonight! And look, they boost you up to 55 whenever you hit the next level. So I'm already halfway to 60. Keep that vibe going. Who would have thunk it was Shauna, of all cards. All right, let's go see who we can boost up here before I head out for the night.
Away.
Ooh, magic. I could put the infinite. Multiple mana, I could put the infinite. What are the cards that I actually use a lot? Shang-Chi, I've been meaning to make infinite. Let's do Shang-Chi. This Wolverine is so cool, though. Isn't that a cool variant? I love this card. You know what? We're going for it. Oh, look at that. Oh, that's it. That was it. That's all I could afford. But I got a couple more I could do. This Nick Fury card is pretty rad. I wish I used it more. I've been using Kazar in this deck, so let's make Kazar shiny logoed. Some say Kazar, I say Kazar. Ooh, 300 more credits! I love this goose variant so much.
I don't need to do anything else. I think I'm just going to call it a night. That was a good note to end on, yeah? Hit level 50. Level up a couple cards. I want to hit 500. I want to get 500 credits so I can put one of those cards to infinite. We've got the theme song going for Guardians. Anyways. A good Marvel Snap session tonight. Thank you all for hanging out. I'll be back tomorrow. I'll be playing some Skullgirls Mobile. You guys know what that game is, right? Pretty good game. So I'll see you then. Thanks for watching. Cheers.